Hello, welcome to the class. So today we will do one more topic, and the name of the topic is torque on a current loop in a uniform magnetic field. So you need a loop. Loop can be in the shape of a rectangle, it can be in the shape of a circle, but you need a closed loop. So this is a current carrying loop, and it is carrying current I. It is kept in a magnetic field. Right? So when it is kept in a magnetic field, it is expected to experience a torque. And why it is expected to experience a torque, we will see in a while that why it is expected to experience a torque. So the magnetic field obviously will be from north to south, and this is how the current is going. So let us first apply the Fleming's left hand rule in order to know the directions of the current. So on this, as you could see, the current is going in the upward direction, and one more thing, mind you, this loop is kept like this. That is it, this is the magnetic field, it is kept perpendicular to this, okay, three dimensional. So that's why I have made it tilted in order to show that three dimensional thing. It is not kept flat like this, right? So this part, Fleming's left hand rule, father, mother, child. Father F force, mother M magnetic field, C child current. Current is going in the upward direction. Magnetic field is going in that direction, so the force on this part will be experienced inwards. So this part will experience a force in the inward direction. So if it is experiencing a force in the inward direction, I am making it as a dot, this force as a dot. You know that dot? Okay, so let it be in this case, actually that is a cross. So it is going inwards. So that is what I am calling F1. Now on this part, if I apply, so again the magnetic field is in this direction, the current is coming downwards, so the force is outwards. So this force, outward force, is what I call F2. So this is F2, so it is coming like this. Now L is the length of this rectangular loop, B is the breadth of this rectangular loop, rectangular coil, PQRS we have named it. And this is kept perpendicular to the field with its axis, actually their axis, with its axis perpendicular. If this is the axis, so this is the coil kept, this is the axis, and it is kept perpendicular to the magnetic field, like this, right? So perpendicular to the magnetic field it is kept. Now let us understand these things. I, the current flowing, A, length into breadth, area is there. Now this is important. What is theta? Theta is the angle between the magnetic field and normal to the plane of the coil. Now if this is the coil, its plane will be just a page, piece of page kept, or a hand kept like this one. So whatever is perpendicular to the coil, whatever is perpendicular to the coil will be perpendicular to the plane itself. Plane means nothing. It's just the portion of the coil where the coil is resting. So if the coil is resting, this is the plane of the coil. So theta is the angle between normal to the plane of the coil and the magnetic field. Mind you, normal to the plane of the coil. Normal to the plane of the coil means normal to the coil also, you can say. So it is not the angle between the coil and the magnetic field. Let me just show it to you here. This is the magnetic field. So, this is the angle between coil and B, that is magnetic field, but this is not theta. What is theta? Theta is normal to the plane of the coil. So, suppose this is normal to the plane of the coil. If this is the coil, this is normal to the plane of the coil. Right? So, how much angle this normal to the plane of the coil is making with magnetic field, that is theta. So, this is theta. Right? So if I call this angle between the magnetic field and the coil has to be alpha, just to tell you. So what is alpha? Alpha is angle between what? B, magnetic field, and coil. And what is theta? Angle between magnetic field and normal to the plane of the coil. Normal to the plane of the coil and magnetic field, the angle is theta. Angle between the magnetic field and the coil is alpha. And this alpha plus theta will be equal to 90 degrees, because this is normal. So if this is normal to the coil, obviously this angle plus this angle would be 90 degree, right? So alpha plus theta would be 90 degree. Now in this case, as you could see that F1 and F2, they are acting in the opposite direction. One is acting inwards and the other is acting outwards. And how much will be the force? So force is acting on this part of the coil whose length is L. So force on our current carrying conductor in a magnetic field, the derivation we have already done. F is equal to B I L sine theta. This theta is 90. Why 90? Because coil is kept perpendicular, with its axis perpendicular to the field. So this is 90 in order to have the maximum force. So how much is F1? F1 will be obviously BIL. How much is F2? It will obviously be BIL. So both the forces are equal and they are acting in opposite direction. One is acting inward, one is acting outwards. So the net force acting on this coil is zero. This is important. Net force acting on this coil is zero. So when two forces are acting on a particular body and they are the forces, two forces are equal and opposite, are in opposite direction, what they tend to form? So they tend to form a torque. So they tend to form a torque. So how much that torque is going to be? So that torque is going to be force into perpendicular distance. How much is force? Force is obviously BIL into, how much is distance, perpendicular distance? Perpendicular distance between what? Perpendicular distance between two forces. See, this is one force acting in the inward direction. I have made it in the upward direction. So upward means inward, and this is downward means it is coming outward. And this will be the, this is the breadth. This is the breadth which is coming between these two forces. So if I make this force here, it is acting inwards, F1, and this force is acting downwards. So what is coming in between these two forces? It's the width of the coil which is coming in between these two forces, right? So if I show it to you with this help of a duster, so if this is the coil kept and one force is acting here and one force is acting here, it is the width which is coming between these two forces, width, right? So this width or the breadth is coming between these two forces, so this is B. If I assume this angle to be theta and if I complete this triangle, then in front of this angle will be perpendicular, this will be base and this will be hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is B, and what I want is, I want this perpendicular I want, because actually I want the perpendicular distance between these two forces. This is the hypotenuse distance between these two forces. Hypotenuse distance between these two forces is B, but I want this perpendicular distance. If you calculate this distance, it is going to be B sine theta. Why B sine theta? Sine theta is equal to perpendicular on hypotenuse. This is angle, this will be perpendicular and this will be hypotenuse. So perpendicular I want to calculate, hypotenuse I have, so B sine theta. So it will come B sine theta. You know length into breadth will be area. So tau is equal to B I A sine theta. So this is the torque which is acting on this body when it is kept within this. If I have n number of turns, then what will happen? If I have n number of turns, for n turns, then it will be n I A B sine theta. If you remember the torque on a dipole, so it is something like that, the torque on a dipole. If you remember the torque on a dipole, it is somewhat the same, the torque on a dipole. For n turns, it is coming like this. Now let me introduce an important term here, which is this NIA. So this NIA means what we call magnetic dipole moment. Mind you, this is the magnetic dipole moment when current is there. So this is the magnetic dipole moment because of the current. N is equal to NIA. So this is the magnetic dipole moment magnetic. Dipole moment, and it is because of current A. So you can easily calculate the unit of this N. So N will not have any unit. I is ampere, area is meter square. So SI unit is ampere meters square. So if I put it back, so tau is equals to mv sine theta. So this will come. Now if I try to write it in the vector form, what will come? In the vector form it will be m tau is equals to m cross, tau is equals to m cross b, cross product, where this is also vector, this is also vector, and this is also vector. So tau is equals to m cross b will come. Now you can form some special cases obviously there, that if theta is 0, then tau will be 0, if theta is 90, then tau will be maximum. So this is the expression, and you should keep this in mind. Now let's begin with some numericals. So let's do some numericals, right? So here is the question. A square coil is given right now. A square coil of size 10 cm consists of 20 turns and carries a current of 12 ampere. So this much information I have given. Size was given, I have converted, I have calculated the area as well. Since it is a square, area will be side square. So side is given 10 cm, converted into meter, it is square like area, the area. Now comes the important thing. The coil is suspended vertically. That is okay. I am normal to the plane of the coil. Now pay attention to this part. Normal to the plane of the coil makes an angle of 30 degrees with the direction of uniform magnetic field. What does it mean? Normal to the plane of the coil. If you remember, theta was the angle between normal to the plane of the coil and the magnetic field. So what is the angle here? If you look at the angle, what is the angle here? So theta is the angle, and if theta is the angle, then what happens? If theta is the angle, theta is the angle between normal to the plane of the coil and magnetic field, and in this case it is given that and normal to the plane of the coil makes an angle 30 degree with the direction of magnetic field. So it means theta is given. So theta is 30 degree and then magnetic field is given, and you have to calculate the torque. So we all know that the formula will be NIA sine theta. So all the informations are given, you have to just multiply them and solve them. So I hope you will be able to do that, and if you figure out the answer, sin 30 is half. If you solve this answer, it will be 0.96 Newton meter. So kindly solve it. I am not solving it for you. You yourself solve it
and then do this part. So this is how you have to do this numerical.
I was just giving you an idea about
this theta angle, right? So theta you all know now.
So let's begin with another one.
Solve it, right? So this is another question, and it's a question of the similar kind which we did earlier. Only few values have been changed. So this can be done as a part of your practice. So here you could see a circular coil of 30 turns and radius 8 cm carrying a current of 6 ampere is suspended vertically in a uniform horizontal magnetic field of 1 Tesla. The field lines makes an angle of 60 degrees. Now this is important. The field lines make an angle of 60 degree with the normal of the coil. Calculate torque. So here you could see the field lines makes an angle of 60 degree with the normal of the coil. So with the normal of the coil, the field lines are making it an angle of 60 degree. You have to calculate the torque, right? So this is the information given. So we will first write the given, and then we will try to solve this question. So let's begin. So if you write the values there, all the values are given. N is given, 20. Radius is given, 8 centimeter. You will convert it into meter. Area you will calculate. This is a circular coil, pi r square. You can easily calculate it. I is given 6 ampere. B is given 1 tesla. Theta is given 60 degree. And then you have to calculate the torque. So torque will be calculated. Nia sin theta. And if you calculate it, Nia sin theta, you will find the value. Here sin 60 is sin 60 is root 3 by 2. If you calculate the value of this torque, it will be 3.13 Newton meter. Torque will be 3.13 Newton meter. Now multiplication and all that, after putting the values, you people have to do it.
So do that part and you will get your answer, right?
So one more I would like to give you as a part of the homework.
So this is the last question. In this also a circular coil is given of 20 turns, radius 10 centimeter, carrying a current of 5 ampere, is suspended vertically in a uniform magnetic field of 0.10 tesla. And in this given that the field lines are normal to the plane of the coil. So read that statement very carefully and try to understand. Find total torque and total average force on the coil. You have to find it. So let me tell you, the answer to both part of the question is zero. Now you have to figure it out why it is zero and then discuss it in the class, right? So that was the homework part. Thank you.